Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir. Mr. Speaker, sir, Honourable Prime Minister, Honourable Ministers, Honourable Leader of Opposition, Honourable Members of Parliament, and Members of the Public. My respectful appreciation to His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Fiji, for a wonderful statement during the opening of the 2019-2020 session of the Parliament last week. It's really sad that His Excellency the President, our distinguished head of state, has not been spared criticism by the opposition. His Excellency spoke eloquently about national pride in our constitution and the growth of civic values. The importance of belonging cannot be overestimated. As Fijians, we build our nation together and are fully invested in its future. Mr. Speaker, sir, we have been chosen to serve this great nation, and we must put this country and its people first in our words and actions. Let us celebrate the tremendous progress made over the past decade and acknowledge the impact of, if I may quote, His Excellency, our 10-year unbroken streak of economic growth. Never has there been any acknowledgement and appreciation of the numerous initiatives and projects that this government has undertaken to uplift the lives of our citizens. There have been frequent attempts to vehemently oppose everything that the government has initiated or done for the advancement of Fijians and the country. The rhetoric that deafens our ears has been that the government's numerous initiatives have been called reckless spending by the opposition. Is providing free education and bus fare to our children, scholarship earned on merit rather than on race, and loans with favorable conditions so that youth can access tertiary education really reckless spending? Or is providing social wages to the majority of our citizens, subsidizing electricity and water, helping farmers, caring for our disabled people and senior citizens, increasing the income threshold where the majority of earners fall, providing housing assistance and spending on markets, roads, bridges, and parks are also reckless spending? Mr. Speaker, sir, the Fiji First Government, under the able leadership of our Prime Minister, has given us a constitution that treats everyone equally, provides security to all citizens, and more importantly, protects our people and Itoke land. Unfortunately, some members of opposition are so entrenched in politics that they oppose everything that this government is doing, not based on substance, but because it comes from this government. There have been rare moments when an opposition member has appreciated government's work. I was pleased that one member of the opposition had the courage to express his gratitude for what this government has done for the development of Namosi province. Thank you, Honorable Mateni Tomboa, for being honest. His Excellency the President had eloquently gave an account of Fiji's progress over the past decade. So please accept and acknowledge this progress. Yes, more can be done, and that is precisely what this government is doing. Mr. Speaker, sir, this Parliament will mark Fiji's 50th anniversary of independence in 2020. As we look to this milestone, we should focus on shared values and agree that we are temporary custodians of this country. This is our time, but tomorrow will belong to our children and our grandchildren. We are accountable to them. If we lay the foundations of sustainable prosperity today, the Fiji that they celebrate 50 years from now will be better than we can even imagine. I'm committed to laying those foundations through my ministerial portfolios and to create opportunities through trade for inclusive and sustainable economic growth across sectors. We will ensure municipal councils become performance-oriented, and we will update local government policies to make it relevant. Mr. Speaker, sir, I will ensure that my ministries are leaders in digitization. There is growing demand for this, especially amongst the 70% of Fijians who are under the age of 40. government will put more services online to make life more convenient for business people, investors, and ordinary people. The Digital Fiji program has been very effective. It has brought services to the palms of all Fijians. For example, business registration used to involve a 9 to 10 day process, but can now be done in a few hours. The BIS Fiji portal is a one-stop online platform that enables investors to obtain information on building permit approvals faster than ever. Mr. Speaker, sir, the Ministry of Local Government is taking decisive measures to significantly improve efficiency and service delivery, mainly through the reform of municipal councils, the development of new townships and upgraded facilities, and strategic cooperation with development partners on town planning. The quality of new leadership at each municipal council is redefining service delivery at the local government level. Our new teams of special administrators across the country have the energy and the commitment demanded by His Excellency the President. They're driving good governance, the modernization of local infrastructure and services, and the professionalism of management and service delivery. The town and city councils have devised strategies to collect outstanding rates and will no longer be lenient with those residents who expect to receive services without paying their share. Council needs rates to invest in maintenance, building and service improvements. Every dollar paid will be put to good use, and citizens will enjoy the returns in the form of more livable environment. Mr. Speaker, sir, the Ministry of Housing and Community Development was established as a standalone ministry in 2018-2019 to make efficient progress on delivering accessible and affordable housing. To date, over 450 families in 5 settlements have received long-term land tenure in the form of 99-year leases as the first step to meeting the housing needs through the informal settlement upgrade and formalization program. Work is progressing in another 9 settlements, and over 1,200 households will benefit. The ministry secured 41 development leases from the Itoke Land Trust Board for that program. Over $3 million has been paid as lease premium, and landowners will continue to receive annual lease rental fees after the development projects are completed. Over the last 5 years, 2,321 Fijians have benefited from the First Home Initiative. There has been higher demand for the First Home First Land Grant assistance, with 336 applications approved in the first quarter of this year. The entire 2018-2019 period saw just 500 applications approved. Interest in home ownership reflects the confidence of the public and the financial sector in the economy. Mr. Speaker, sir, there are unscrupulous slumlords who charge excessive rents and opportunists who try to take advantage of government's program to grab land from those in genuine need. A stronger and fairer policy and regulatory framework will address this. A review of housing policies and related programs has begun in collaboration with a housing policy advisor from New Zealand. In addition, both the Housing Authority and the Public Rental Board will be restructured to improve service delivery. Mr. Speaker, sir, another initiative on affordable home ownership is through Strata Title. The government is working with the International Finance Corporation to assist in the design and implementation of housing projects under public-private partnership arrangement. 6 sites in Central and Western Division have been selected for the due diligence to develop green and climate-resilient housing units for low- to middle-income households in Fiji with private sector participation. The 2019-2020 budget also proposes several tax concessions to those from private sector investing in residential housing. Mr. Speaker, sir, as stated by His Excellency the President, global forces such as trade wars between economic powerhouses and the slowdown of economies of our trading partners have an impact on our economy. After all, Fiji is part of the international trade ecosystem. The forecasted growth, global growth rate is 3%, the lowest since 2008-2009. Given this challenge, my ministry is working closely with countries such as Australia, New Zealand, China, Indonesia, New Caledonia for preferential market access for Fijian-made goods. The Australian government is working on a pilot program that will look at permanent cover export for commercial purposes by the end of 2020. Recently, Australia has completed risk assessment study on breadfruit, which means as soon as the technical details are sorted, we can start exporting fresh breadfruit to Australia. As His Excellency, the President stated that we should not treat the economy as a political football. The Honourable Leader of Opposition and Honourable Linda Tumbuya have paid no heed to this statement. All that happens from such point scoring is actually undermining the economy from within. In light of the global economic slowdown, the Minister for Economy introduced the pro-growth and pro-business support policies in the 2019-2020 national budget. The 2019-2020 budget provides the much-needed confidence in the country's economy. So how can you say lack of confidence in government is the reason for slow growth? Yes. Mr. Speaker, sir, I wish to point out that the World Bank Group Doing Business report has missed on the number of regulatory reforms that was recently undertaken, such as BizPortal and the areas of getting credit. It is widely known that the Ease of Doing Business report's methodology is flawed. However, we have undertaken a commitment to drastically improve doing business in Fiji and subsequently our ratings. My ministry, with the support from the Singaporean government, is working on obtaining construction permits and starting a business application approval and payment entirely online by September 2020 and September 2021, respectively. Also, there are significant reforms being undertaken to reduce time to obtain business license in Fiji. Mr. Speaker, sir, an investment in youth is an investment in our country's future. My ministry's Young Entrepreneurship Scheme, known as YES, provides grants to entrepreneurs that financial institutions are unwilling to support due to lack of collateral. The YES program has many inspiring success stories that we have highlighted. Take Adeline Tutu, aged 27 years, who started Get Lean Fiji. Her mobile fitness app already has around 700 users. Winston Hill established BoxFit Fiji, the Pacific's first boxing gym franchise. 25-year-old Leo Vanualailai set up Fiji's first 100% locally owned GIS service provider. Rinesh Sharma created IntroGreen Distribution, combining engineering with agriculture to plant in an ICT-controlled environment. It is no coincidence that 3 out of 4 of these examples involve ICT. Our youth must be encouraged to use ICT boldly and creatively. My ministry is also introducing the Research and Innovation Scheme for Enterprises called RICE to support local enterprises and entrepreneurs who carry out research and development and use science to deliver creative solutions for businesses. Mr. Speaker, sir, tourism remains the mainstay of the Fijian economy. Tourism arrivals have increased by 4% in the 9 months of this year, compared to the same period last year. Our earnings from tourism in the first half of this year increased by approximately 7% compared to the same period last year. My ministry introduced an online international business survey this year following a review by the ministry and the IFC. This provides real-time data for targeted planning and analysis. We also worked with IFC on the recently launched assessment of the economic impact of cruise tourism, which quantified impacts and revealed investment opportunities that could inject an additional $43.98 million into the Fijian economy over 10 years. His Excellency rightfully mentioned that we can create more economic activities by looking inward and at new opportunities. This means diversifying our markets, products, and destinations. Mr. Speaker, sir, despite political differences, we can all agree that our nation must have a strong economy with plentiful opportunities for all. A strong economy will free every Fijian child to be ambitious and to dream big, as their dreams will be attainable. We want every child to dream without limits, to access support and training while working hard, and to know that their successes will be celebrated and it will inspire others. That is how Fiji can be, if we can avoid politicizing every achievement. I once again commend His Excellency the President for his inspiring words at the opening of Parliament. I'm pleased to reiterate my pledge to work wholeheartedly through my ministerial portfolios and to ensure a bright and prosperous future for all Fijians. Tunakavakulevu, Tanewad, and God bless Fiji.